is our president-elect, Donald Trump. Now, he believes in the Second Amendment, but he also believes that there should be restrictions on gun control. And the restrictions he believes in is the no-fly, no-buy policy, which means that if you're on the no-fly list, which is a terrorist watch list that the United States has, you cannot purchase a firearm. How, this is according to the Huffington Post. But this cannot happen because, as of right now, the no-fly list is a secretive list that the government has not released. And if they released it, it would risk exposing multiple government operations and things like that. Now, as I'm not surprised, according to my audience analysis, 60% are not interested in gun control and gun policies. And a good percent of Americans, including President-elect Trump, are not clear on how they can help, and they don't realize that their voice is needed for change. Now, why is gun control such a problem? This is because according to the Brady campaign in 2016, gun violence is a problem because every day 90 people die in America from it. 31 are murdered, 56 from suicide, 2 killed unintentionally, 1 is killed by police intervention, and 1 is with intent unknown. Now, as all of you know, last week there was an attack at Ohio State University. Now, this didn't actually have a gun involved, except for the police officer who shot and killed the suspect. But it was originally reported as a shooter, which just shows how fearful our country has become of mass shootings on college campuses. And this is from CNN in 2016. Now, one solution that is always called for is background checks. However, Brady background checks, they have prevented 2.4 million people from buying guns, but this number is very small if you really consider how long we've had a background check at reputable gun dealers. This is according to the Dan Gross's TED Talk in 2016. Now, the reason why this number seems extremely small is, while it does seem large, reputable gun dealers doesn't count for online purchases or the gun show loophole. And because there are so many flaws with this, there's also a good amount of people with mental illness who are also looked over. Now, that may seem like a big jump in logic, but gun violence can be prevented by mental health being monitored and brought to everyone's attention. Now, there are actually very few things that are restricting people diagnosed with a mental illness from acquiring handguns. It is said, and I quote, "Under a federal law enacted in 1968, an individual is prohibited from buying or possessing firearms for life if he or she has been educated as a mental defective or committed to a mental institution. A person is educated as a mental defective if a court has made a determination that an individual, as a result of mental illness, is a danger to himself or others, lacks mental capacity to contract or manage his own affairs, is found insane by the court in a criminal case, or incompetent to stand trial." This is from the Coalition to Stop Gun Violence. Now, the bad thing about this, while it's a step, it doesn't help those who are not treated, and it also doesn't prevent those without a history of violence to acquire guns. Now, this doesn't mean that everyone with a mental illness is dangerous. It's just that if a mental illness goes for a long time untreated, it can soon build and grow into a more severe situation. Now, however, those not being treated also risk being part of the 79% of mass shooters that have mental illness. 79% may not seem like a lot, but when you take into consideration that just last year there were 300 mass shootings, according to BBC last year, this number is astoundingly large. And because we know that gun violence is a bad thing, and we know how to resolve it, we must think, how can we as individuals solve this problem? Now, the best start is locally. Now, there are three things that we can do. We can write a state representative, we can donate money, or we can volunteer. Now, according to my audience analysis, 80% think writing doesn't work. However, a political scientist at the University of Bologna wrote every single state representative, and 1 in 5 wrote back in exactly one day. This is according to BillMyers.com in 2012. Now, the thing is, just because they didn't reply doesn't mean they didn't read it. And another thing is, the more people write them or more emails are sent, the more likely the politicians are actually going to address problems. Now, another way to do this is through donations. Now, a charity is not considered a good charity unless if it uses less than 33% of its profits for other things besides the cause. And these are some of these are some places you can donate money. The first is Everytown Gun Safety, which is focusing on safer communities, but they're not against gun ownership. Americans for Responsible Solutions, they try to elect politicians that want more responsible gun ownership laws. Stop Handgun Violence Groups, which wants more laws for gun ownership. And the American Psychological Association, which really helps try to help treat those with mental illness. And the final thing you can do is volunteer. The closest place you can volunteer here in Muncie is the Unity Center. And you may have seen the billboards around, but there is actually a program that tries to teach kids the dangers of guns and also how to report gun violence that they have seen. And finally, in conclusion, what we talked about was that gun violence is a dangerous and very bad thing, but it also can be prevented by looking at the cause of mental illness. And if we use our voices together, we can all bring change that we need in this world. Thank you.